today, 5th September 2019, 2 years to the date, virtually 8:15, 8:30 p.m. and Gauri Lankesh, intrepid Kannada journalist, was shot dead just outside her home in Rajarajeshwari Nagar, Bangalore. Known for her brave and fearless journalism and committed to social activism, Gauri Lankesh is no more with us, but there's now an award instituted in her name, and the first recipient of that award is none less than Ravish Kumar of NDTV India. What's in it in the world of press freedom and journalism in India? Aaj Kal kya kya ho raha hai? Kashmir, we are getting increasing reports. It's 1 month since the clampdown on the valley and the abrogation of Article 370. Journalists in Kashmir, we are being told by a fact-finding team that just returned last night, are under threat, are under surveillance. Three journalists who are living in government quarters have been asked to move out. There are various forms of intimidation being indulged in by the the intelligence authorities and the police. Matlab, patrakar apna kaam Kashmir wadi mein nahi kar pa rahe hain. Not only that, a scandalous incident in Mirzapur district of Uttar Pradesh, where Pawan Kumar Jaiswal, a young journalist who was exposing the scandal in the midday meal scheme, where chote chote bachchon ko roti aur namak khane pe majboor kar raha tha, unhone ek video nikala jo patrakar ka ek farz banta hai ki is tarah ki cheez ko expose karna, aur unke khilaf prashasan ne ek FIR darj kiya. He has been accused of a criminal conspiracy, if you please, when all he was doing was following the first tenets of his profession, which is to expose the establishment, which was feeding just chapati and salt to young children under the midday meal scheme. So Kashmir, Mirzapur, Uttar Pradesh, all over India, a climate of fear, and also Assam, post the release of the NRC final list, suddenly we find that the MHA, Ministry of Home Affairs, and the Ministry of External Affairs has declared Assam a protected area and has not allowed foreign journalists and will not allow foreign journalists to go there and freely report. If they want to go, they need to apply to the ministry, get special permits and permission. Only can they travel in Assam. So Assam now joins Kashmir and another northeastern state in denying foreign media free movement. Editors Guild was a little late to respond vis-a-vis the Kashmir Valley situation, but has responded in the case of Pawan Kumar Jaiswal and condemned the UP administration and government for registering the FIR. The Press Council of India, on the other hand, came in for a lot of criticism when it actually sought to intervene in a petition by Anuradha Bhasin Jamwal, who is the editor of Greater Kashmir, who has urged the Supreme Court for a lifting up of all the bans against the free media in the valley and Jammu. Petition not being heard, she's filed an additional affidavit, and now those petitions in the Supreme Court are posted for September 16th. All in all, not a very happy story for press freedom in India. Kahin na kahin patrakar aur patrakaron ke upar, patrakarita ke upar, sarkar ek tarah ka jaal phasane ki koshish kar rahi, bhay aur ka vatavaran paida karne ki koshish kar rahi, taki hum aur aap patrakar apna kaam nahi kar sake. Will the Indian media cow down, or will they show a stronger face to the establishment? Only time will tell. Remember, we've lived through the emergency in 1975 to 1977. People are calling this an undeclared state of emergency in India. Let's see how individual journalists and powerful media houses hold up.